environmental studies textbook, and today we are going to start our new lesson, beaks and claws. Okay, they're related to the birds. Okay, beaks and claws. Open page number 53 in your textbooks, everyone. Page number 53. Okay, birds are living beings. They need food to live. They do not have teeth to eat and chew their food. They have beaks to eat food. Different birds have different kinds of beaks and claws. The shape of a bird's beak and claws depends on the food it eats. See, birds, first of all, birds are the living beings. They are also living like us only, no children. And they need food to live. So how can any creature will live? First of all, they need sufficient food and air to live. Yes or no? In the same way, birds also need food to live. And they do not have teeth to eat and chew their food. They don't have the teeth. We have the teeth, and some of the animals also will have the teeth. Whereas birds, they don't have the teeth. They have only the beaks, okay? See, different birds have different kinds of beaks and claws. So many different types of birds are there in our environment. They differ in beaks, children. One bird will have the different size and another one will have the different size. The shape of a bird's beak and claws depends on the food it eats. So how the beaks will be, children? It totally depends upon the food what it is eating. Okay, in that way their beaks will be. Okay, now about the beak. The beak of a bird that eats nuts differ from the beak of a bird that eats flesh. See, here suppose if you take two examples of birds, if you compare two beaks, so the beak of a bird which is eating nuts will be very much different from the beak of a bird which eats the flesh. Okay, it may be sharp, it may be blunt, it may be short, or it may be some curl like that. Okay, now birds use beaks for eating, feeding their young ones, gathering nestling materials, building nests, scratching and attacking. So in all these ways they'll use their beaks only, children. So what are those? First of all, beaks for eating, for enti tinadaniki, feeding their young ones. See, they'll collect some food material, no? They'll keep in their beak and they'll bring to their kids and they'll put that into their mouths. A baby bottle loki a beak tone vaati note loki pettaranamata. Okay, at gathering nesting materials, they'll construct the nest, no, children? Trees loni kattuntaru kada. So for that also they will collect the nest materials by using its beak. Okay, and building nests, nest form cheyadaniki kuda they'll use the beaks only. And scratching and attacking. Scratching means if they have the itching sensation, no, they will scratch like this. And attacking, if they want to fight, no, they will go with their beak first. Okay, now here are some common types of beaks according to the food habits of the birds. So he has given the description about the remaining birds, how they are attacking and how the beaks will be. Okay, now the first one is cracker beak. See, let us see. Seed eaters like sparrows, peacocks, pigeons and hens have short, thick and conical beak to break and crush seeds. See, what are the what is it, birds, children? Sparrows, peacocks, pigeons and hens. How their beak will be? It's a very short one and very thick one, and it will be in the conical beak. Conical beaks to break and crush seeds. Seeds ni break cheyadaniki ilaagilaaga podu cheyadaniki vaatiki veeluga untundannamata veeti beaks. They are called the cracker beak. Ee birds kundeetvanti beaks ni what do we call that as? It's a cracker beak. Okay, next one is hooked beak. See, hawks, owls, eagles and vultures which catch and kill their prey have sharp hooked beaks. So ikkada hooked beaks ela untayante chaala very sharp ga untayi anamata. Vatni catch chestante enti, ivi evarnaithe attack cheyalanukuntunavo they will attack with their beak only. Okay, so what examples enti? Hawks, owls, eagles and vultures which catch and kill their prey have sharp hooked beaks. These are used to bite and tear the prey into pieces small enough to swallow. They are very small enough to swallow. Ante enti, they will cut them into the small pieces. Okay, they will cut them into small pieces. Avi chinni chinni ga crush chesesi chinna chinna ga chesestai tinadaniki veeluga undelaaga. Next one is chisel shaped beak. What is that? Woodpeckers have strong chisel like beaks that tap the trunk of the tree. See in the picture, sharp ga podugga untundannamata, oka kattari laaga anamata. Okay, such beaks help them to make holes in the hard tree trunks. So alanti beak daniki ela use avutundi? Trunks untayi kada trees ki, vaatiki ila hole chestuntayi, they want that. Okay, so for that it will be very useful, this type of beaks. It is also used to catch insects hiding in the trunks. Ante kaakunda trunks meedu undetvanti insects ni kuda adi easy ga catch cheyagalugutundi with this chisel beaks. Okay, chisel shaped beaks anamata we vaguely kuntai woodpeckers ki okay next probe beak means what the beaks of hummingbirds are long and slender like straws humming beaks anamata long ilaaga straws laaga untai they use their beaks to probe or sip nectar from flowers ante adi parisodhistu untundi chutupakkala em unnai ante mukkuto ilaa tosukuntu chustu untund anamata okay and nectar from flowers aa flowers lo nectar untundi kada dani kuda suck cheyadaniki easy ga untundi vaatiki now turn the page children and tweezer beak means what this long pointed beaks are found mainly in insect eaters like hoppy and warbler they are used to pick or tweeze insects of leaves twigs and bark so this one tweezer beak enti laga poduga untundannamata veevi kuda em chestayi and this type will be on what is that hoppy and warbler birds lo ekkuva kanipistuntundi okay are found mainly in the insect eaters ivi insect eaters ee both kuda chinna chinna insects ni tinestu untai they are used to pick or tweeze insects of leaves akkada tweeze insects leaves meed undetvanti chinna chinna purugulu aa vaatilni collect cheyadaniki vitka beak use avutundi and bugs next one is a strainer beak means what ducks have broad and flat beak with a hole on it ducks kundetvanti vaatilni strainer beaks antaru ducks ki ela untayi ma dalasariga very hard ga untayi and broad ga flat ga untayi ila untundi kada and with a hole on it then beak meda oka hole kuda untundi see in the picture it is given there okay a strain insects and worms from water it will use it for its because always we can see some of the ducks will be in the water only now okay it will catches the insects with that one okay with that type of beaks next is a spear beak means what birds like herons and kingfishers have spear like long sharp pointed beaks for fishing so beetliki herons ki kingfishers ki long ga untundi sharp ga untundi and pointed beak ante chala soothi ga untund anamata okay and these are used for fishing and fishing chala easy ga chestai they can catch the fish in the ponds or the lakes or wherever it is okay herons pick their prey up with their curved beaks and gulp it down so vaatlu tha catch chesesi gattiga pattukoni kinda pettukoni they will eat okay and swiss army knife beak see crows have multi purpose beak this crows regularly we'll see you know they'll have the multi purpose beaks they use their beaks to eat fruits seeds insects fish and other animals so for this bird can eat anything children what is that crow okay so in that way its beak will be okay crows have multi purpose beaks so with that beak it can eat what fruits seeds insects fish and other animals okay remaining we'll continue in the next class children and today's your homework task is from page number 57 everyone see the page number 57 the first question is why do birds have a beak and the second one why do hawks have hooked beaks these two questions you have to read and write one time in your homework book if you don't have the books they are available in our school campus come and buy them parallelly along with this book you have one more workbook children in that you have the answers okay write the homework without fail have a good day children thank you